the last class we discussed the differences between distance and displacement. Distance will be the actual length of the path traveled by the body, and displacement will be the shortest path between initial and final points. That will be called as the displacement. Distance will be a scalar quantity, displacement will be a vector quantity. What is the relation between distance and displacement means? Displacement value less than or equal to distance. Displacement less than or equal to distance. It will be never greater than distance. Displacement may be equal to distance. Maybe less than displacement is maybe less than distance, but it will be never equal to distance, never greater than distance. Remember that. Okay, and displacement may be positive, may be negative, may be zero. We discussed some examples. If the body came to the starting point again, then displacement value will be equal to zero. If it went back in the same direction, displacement may be negative, but distance will be always positive. Distance will be always positive. Displacement may be negative, may be positive, may be zero. So those are the differences between displacement and distance. Next, see some more basic definitions. What is meant by speed and what is meant by velocity? The distance traveled by a body in 1 second. The distance traveled by a body in 1 second is called speed. In 1 second, body will travel how much distance? That distance will be called as the speed. Then speed is equal to distance by time. It will be a scalar quantity. Distance is a scalar, time is a scalar. That's why it will be a scalar quantity. What is its SI unit? What is its CDS unit means? Its SI unit will be meter per second. What is its CGS unit means? This value will be centimeter per second. What is its dimensional formula means? Dimensional formula will be L T power minus 1. So the distance traveled by the body in 1 second, that will be called as the speed. Next, what is meant by velocity? The displacement of the body traveled by a body in 1 second is called velocity. This value will be velocity is equal to displacement by time. Clear understanding? Velocity is equal to displacement by time. Next, it will be a vector quantity. It is not a scalar quantity. It will be a vector quantity. So the distance traveled by the body in 1 second, that will be called as the speed. The displacement traveled by the body in 1 second, that will be called as the velocity. Velocity is equal to displacement by time. It is a vector quantity. Okay. SI unit will be same meter per second. CGS unit will be centimeter per second. Dimensional formula will be L T power minus 1. Clear? Next. After finishing of this, can you understand? Are you understand? What is the difference between them? So again, same speed will be always positive. Velocity may be positive, may be negative, may be zero. Next. What is meant by instantaneous velocity? What is meant by instantaneous velocity? The velocity of a body at a particular instant of time is called instantaneous velocity. The velocity of a body at a particular instant of time. The velocity of a body at a particular instant of time is called instantaneous velocity. Now, what is the velocity of the body at this time? That velocity will be called instantaneous velocity. Clear? Next, after finishing of this, instantaneous velocity to calculate this one formula we will write limit delta t tends to 0 delta s by delta t that is equal to ds by dt. Just remember it as the formula. What is meant by limit, what is delta s, all these are not required. Just if delta t is very small, it's delta t tending to 0, delta s by delta t limit in terms of mathematics, we will represent like that. That value will be equal to ds by dt. The velocity, so if you take any speedometer, that will be called as the odometer also. If you all vehicles will have that speedometer, so every two-wheeler, four-wheeler means bikes, cars, lorry, they are having the speedometers. The speedometer reading will represent the instantaneous velocity of that vehicle at that time. Now it is showing 60 km/h, means you are going with that velocity. Clear? Next, after this, what is meant by uniform velocity? What is meant by uniform velocity? Okay. Uniform velocity means if a body travels, equal displacements ये बॉडी ट्रेवल्स इक्वल डिस्प्लेसमेंट्स इन इक्वल इंटरवल्स ऑफ टाइम in equal intervals of time, however small these intervals may be. However, small these intervals may be, means how the small intervals may be, no need to consider. Whether the time interval is may be small, may be big, no need to consider that one. If the body travels equal displacements in equal intervals of time, then the body is said to be. Then the body is said to be moving with uniform velocity. Body is said to be moving with uniform velocity. Once again, listen what we are discussing. If a body travels equal displacements in equal intervals of time, however small these intervals may be, then the body is said to be moving with uniform velocity. For example, a body is moving in the first second of its motion, it traveled 10 meters. In the second second of its motion, it traveled same 10 meters. In the third second of its motion, it traveled the same 10 meters. So, in equal intervals of time, body travels equal amounts of displacements, then body is said to be moving with uniform velocity. Clear? For example, observe the seconds hand, minutes hand, hours hand in the watch, what will happen? Every 5 seconds it will comes to 1, 2, 3, like that it will be there in the watch. So what will happen, this is the watch. In 15 seconds that second hand will come to here. It will cover here an angle of 90 degrees. Next 15 seconds it will come to here. Next 15 seconds it will come to here. Next 15 seconds it will come to here, like that. Every 15 seconds or every 5 seconds it will cover some angle that will be same. So we can say it is moving with uniform, actually speaking, angular velocity. For your understanding I am saying it will be moves with angular velocity. So uniform velocity. So in equal time intervals, body covers equal displacements, then body is said to be moving with uniform velocity. Next, non-uniform velocity. If a body travels unequal displacements, a body travels unequal displacements in equal intervals of time, however small these intervals may be, then the body is said to be moving with non-uniform velocity. Then body is said to be moving with non-uniform velocity. Clear? So in this manner we can define the uniform velocity and non-uniform velocity. Clear? Next, after finishing of this uniform velocity and non-uniform velocity, we can take a lorry moving on the road. its displacements covered by heat is not uniform. Definitely it will be non-uniform only, unequal only, that's why we can consider it is moving with non-uniform velocity. Clear? Next. After finishing of this, what is meant by average velocity? What is meant by average velocity? So the ratio of total displacement and total time is called average velocity. The ratio of total displacement and total time is called average velocity. Clear? So average velocity is equal to total displacement by total time. Okay, so we can write this as S1 plus S2 plus S3 plus so on, T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus so on. So some displacements are there in some time intervals. Then to calculate the average velocity, we can use the formula S1 plus S2 plus S3 plus so on by T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus so on. Clear? Next. In some problems, they won't give displacements. They will give velocity and times. They will ask to calculate, find the average velocity. Then we have to use S is equal to Vt. So it will becomes V1 T1 plus V2 T2 plus V3 T3 by T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus so on. Clear? Next. If they gave displacement and velocity, they asked to calculate the average velocity, then this value will be S1 plus S2 plus S3 plus so on by S1 by V1 plus S2 by V2 plus S3 by V3 plus so on. This formula we will use to find the average velocity. Once again, listen what I am saying. To find the average velocity, what is the formula? Total displacement by total time. Some displacements in some time intervals is given. Then S1 plus S2 plus S3 so on by T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus so on. Sometimes they will give velocity and time. They will ask to calculate average velocity. V1 T1 plus V2 T2 so on, V3 T3 so on by T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus so on. Sometimes if they give displacement and velocity, if they ask to calculate the average velocity, S1 plus S2 plus S3 so on by S1 by V1 plus S2 by V2 plus S3 by V3 so on. This formula we will use to find the average velocity. Clear understanding? Up to now what we discussed, see? Initially we discussed what is the relation between displacement and distance. What is the relation? Displacement less than or equal to distance. If body moves in the straight line, then only displacement and distance will be equal. If body is not moving in the straight line, then the displacement value will be always less than the distance. Next, what is meant by speed? What is meant by velocity? Next, what is meant by average velocity? What is meant by uniform velocity? Non-uniform velocity, both are completed. Next, what is meant by average velocity? That is completed. Next, see what is meant by acceleration. Next, what is meant by acceleration? Acceleration is indicated by the letter small a. Accelerating means if velocity is increasing, we can say body is accelerating. If velocity is decreasing, we can say body is decelerating. Clear? If velocity is increasing, we can say body is accelerating. If velocity is decreasing for a body, then we can say body is decelerating or retarding. Okay? So for example, if you take a train, train started from a station. Another station is far away from it. Then what will happen? Gradually its velocity will increase. We can say train is accelerating. While reaching to the another station, gradually train velocity will decrease and finally it will stop at the another station. While reaching to the other station, nearer to the station, we can say train is retarding. Velocity of the train is decreasing with time. We can say train is retarding. Okay? So acceleration means how we will say is the rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. The rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. A is equal to change in velocity by time. This value will be v minus u, this is t. So A is equal to v minus u by t. Clear? So here u will be initial velocity. So symbol for initial velocity will be u. V will be final velocity. T will be time, initial velocity, final velocity, and T will be the time. A is what? Acceleration. Okay? See, here velocity is vector quantity. Change in the velocity will also be a vector quantity. Okay? So, it is a vector quantity. Acceleration will be a vector quantity. If we write its CGS unit, change in the velocity will have same units. So this will be meter per second by second, totally meter per centimeter per second. So OCDS unit will be centimeter per second square. If you write SI unit, it will be meter per second square. If you write dimensional formula, L T power minus 2. Clear? So the rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. Acceleration formula will be change in velocity by time, or V minus U by T, where U will be called initial velocity, V will be called final velocity, T will be time. Since velocity is a vector quantity, change in velocity is also a vector quantity. So it will be a vector quantity, vector by scalar. So again it is a vector. So its CGS unit will be centimeter per second square. Its SI unit will be meter per second square. Its dimensional formula will be L T power 2. If velocity of the body is gradually increasing, we can say body is accelerating. Velocity of the body is decreasing, we can say body is decelerating or retarding. So next, here one more point. Change in velocity.
Use the relation between
equations of motion gives the relation between initial velocity, final velocity, time, acceleration and displacement. Clear? Once again, see, equations of motion will give the relation between initial velocity, final velocity, time, acceleration and displacement. So what is the relation between all these? Those are represented by equations of motion. These are valid when body is moving with uniform acceleration. When body is moving with uniform acceleration, the relation between these quantities is given by equations of motion. Remember, first one will be, you know about this, first one will be V is equal to U plus AT, second S is equal to UT plus half AT square, 3 V square minus U square is equal to 2AS, 4th SN is equal to U plus A into N minus half. So these are the equations of motion when body is moving with uniform velocity. What are the equations of motion? V is equal to U plus AT, S is equal to UT plus half AT square, V square minus U square is equal to 2AS, SN is equal to U plus A into N minus half. Next, what is the difference between, already these derivations for you came in the earlier classes already for you. Okay, already these are came for you in the earlier classes, no need to derive once again. Next we will see that part. What is this and what is this SN? S will be distance travelled by the body in t seconds. SN will be distance travelled by the body in the nth second. SN will be distance travelled by the body in the nth second. S will be distance travelled by the body in t second. What is the difference between this? We will try to understand. We will derive that equation also. Let us see. So these are the equations of motion. When these are applicable? When body is moving with uniform acceleration, then only these equations will be applicable. Next, SN is equal to U plus A into N minus half. How to derive that equation? What is the meaning of that equation? See, for example, body is moving with uniform acceleration. Body is moving with uniform acceleration. In 5 seconds time, a body came from here to there. In 5 seconds time, body went from here to there. It covered a distance of 50 meters. period time of 5 seconds. In a time of 5 seconds, body covered a distance of 15 meters. Clear? Now, in the first second of its journey, it covered 8 meters. In the first second of its journey, it covered 8 meters. In the second second, it covered 10 meters. In the third second, it covered 12 meters, for example. So, in the fourth second, it covered 14 meters. In the fifth second, it covered 16 meters. Total, it will be 16 again, not 15. Okay. In 5 seconds of total time, body covered how much distance? 16 meters. So 8 plus 10, 18 plus 12, 30, 30 plus 30, it will be 60. Okay. Now if they ask, what is the total distance traveled in 5 seconds time, calculate. Then you have to use the formula, S is equal to ut plus half at square. In total 2 seconds, what is the displacement of the body? In 3 seconds, what is the displacement of the body? In 4 seconds, what is the displacement of the body? Calculate. Then you have to use the formula, S is equal to ut plus half at square. In a particular second, in the third second, what is the displacement of the body? In the fourth second, what is the displacement of the body? In the fifth second, what is the displacement of the body? Then you have to use Sn is equal to u plus a into n minus half. Try to understand. In 5 second time, body traveled 60 meters. In the 5 second time, body traveled 60 meters. Okay. In the 5th second, body traveled 16 meters. To calculate the displacement in a particular second, you have to use the formula Sn is equal to u plus a into n minus half. Okay? Next. In the total time you calculate, means you have to use the formula S is equal to ut plus half at square. Okay. S is equal to ut plus half at square means total time. 5 seconds. In 4 seconds, then you have to use that formula. In a particular time, once a particular time interval, find the displacement means you have to use this formula. How this formula is gained? We will derive this formula. So, Sn is equal to u plus a into n minus half. How to derive this one? Already the three formulas are there. Na? V is equal to u plus a t, S is equal to ut plus half a t square. V square minus U square is equal to 2A is already derived only in the earlier classes in the 9th and 8th. you derive that formulas, once again no need to derive that. Only this formula, how to derive, you will see. So, for this, consider a body, having initial velocity. Consider a body having initial velocity u. Moving with uniform acceleration a. Body's uniform acceleration is a. Body's initial velocity, let it be u. Next. Let S1 be the displacement of the body in n seconds. S1 be the displacement of the body in n seconds. Then S1 is equal to what will happen? Un plus half AN squared. S1 is equal to un plus half an squared. Next. Let S2 be the displacement of the body in n minus 1 seconds. S2 will be u into n minus 1 plus half a into n minus 1 whole square. Using the formula S is equal to ut plus half a t square. S1 value will be how much? Un plus half an square. S2 value will be how much? U into n minus 1 plus half a into n minus 1. So, body is going like this. In the n seconds, body traveled a distance S1. In the n minus 1 seconds, body traveled a displacement S2. This will be what then? Sn. Displacement in the nth second will be equal to S1 minus S2. Okay, try to calculate that. Therefore, displacement of the body. Therefore, displacement of the body in nth second Sn is equal to S1 minus S2. Okay, Sn is equal to un plus half an squared plus half a into n minus 1 whole squared. Okay, displacement in the nth second means we have to subtract this one from this one. Then SN is equal to what will happen? UN plus half AN square minus UN minus U plus half A into N square plus 1 minus UN. So SN is equal to UN plus half AN square UN minus U plus half AN square plus A by 2 minus AN. Then expand this. UN plus half AN square minus UN plus U minus half AN square minus A by 2 plus AN. So UN will cancel. Half AN square, half AN square will cancel. Then what we will get? SN is equal to U minus A by 2 plus AN. In this you take A as common. SN is equal to U plus A into N minus half. So this is the equation. So if they want to calculate displacement in the nth second, you had to use the formula SN is equal to U plus A into N minus half. These four will be considered as the equations of motion. SN is equal to U plus A into N minus half. Next, what is meant by instantaneous? The acceleration of a body at a particular instant of time, that will be called as the instantaneous acceleration. The acceleration of a body at a particular instant of time, the acceleration of a body at a particular instant of time is called instantaneous acceleration. Limit delta t tends to 0, delta v by delta t, like that we can write this one. Okay, so this value will be dv by dt. So A is equal to dv by dt, that is the formula. In another format we can write this one. So A is equal to dv by dt. D by dt of v means ds by dt. This one we can write it as d square s by dt square. So A is equal to d square s by dt square. Or A is equal to dv by dt. Those are the different formulas for acceleration, instantaneous acceleration. One more formula is there, you see. A is equal to dv by dt. D square s by dt square. then we will write this one in this format. A is equal to dv by ds into ds by d. From this, I divided with ds and multiplied with ds. Ds, ds will cancel. Again, dv by dt. But ds by dt is equal to v. So, dv by ds into v. A is equal to v into dv by ds. That is the formula for acceleration. A is equal to v into dv by ds. Okay? With this, we will stop today. In the next class, graphs will be there. Displacement time graph, velocity time graph, and acceleration time graph will be there. We will discuss detailedly about that graphs, and from that graphs, how to derive v is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square, v square minus u square is equal to 2as. We will discuss that in the next class. Okay? Today we will stop with this. Okay.